Lord, the righteous judge will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. Our race must be run with perseverance, that is, with patience and endurance. We Christians, we are compared to the runners that run in a race. Those who compete in the games go into strict training just to get the prize that will not last. But our prize is different from them. It will last forever. So we are like runners that we have to train ourselves to run with perseverance, with patience, to win the prize. In running the race, we have to concentrate on running without looking right or left or looking back. Because if we do, it will cause us to stumble or to fall. In Christian life, there are a lot of stumbling blocks to test our faith. Sometimes we cannot avoid to stumble or to fall. We don't like it, but it happens. But when it happens, get up and run again, because the prize is still there, waiting for us. If we stumble or we fall, get up and run again. Don't stop, because if we stop, it leads us to backsliding, and we will lose the prize. But because God loves us, He gives us chance to run again for the second time. But we have to start from the beginning again. Like myself, I started to run my race, but I fell and I stopped. But God gave me a chance to run again for the second time. But you know what? To come to the Lord again was not easy for me, because my heart hardened because of sin. Everything that I have learned from the Lord, Satan stole them all, and I have to start from the beginning again. So my brothers and sisters, don't stop. Keep on running to win the prize. In running the race, we have to fix our eyes on Jesus and not on men or on other Christians. Because sometimes we are fixing or focusing our eyes on them, on other Christians, especially to the mature ones, like the leaders of the church, the elders, or sometimes the pastor. Sometimes we make them as our pattern in serving the Lord. But how about if they fall? It will cause us to fall as well. For example, myself. My brothers and sisters, please let me use myself as an example because it is easy for me. For example, myself. Now you see that I am sharing the word of God. So you are expecting more in serving the Lord. But how about if one day, for example, I have done wrong or I have sinned? God forbid. What will you feel? What will you say? Am I sharing the word of God? And now he's doing this? Probably some of you, it will cause you to stumble. It will cause you to become weak. That's why don't focus our eyes or fix our eyes on men, but on Jesus, the perfect one, the holy and the righteous one. Because we are not perfect, we have weaknesses, we have negative characters. I am saying this, that we are not perfect, we have weaknesses, we have negative characters. It doesn't mean that I am justifying ourselves that we can go into sin. No. But instead, I am encouraging you to be Christ-like, the goal of Christian maturity. But don't be confused. confused about fellowship with other Christians and fixing or focusing our eyes on them. It is very important for us to have fellowship with other Christians because we don't grow up alone. We need others to grow. We need fellowship and encouragement. But what I mean is, don't fix or focus our eyes on them. Because if we do, I assure you, we will not continue. Because I experience it. Not only because of my work, I became backslider, but also because of some Christians around me that I fixed my eyes on them. But now I know, just on Jesus. Because otherwise, I will be disqualified again. In doing sin while we are serving the Lord, in this way, we are putting the name of our Lord in shame. God loved us so much, that's why He provided a plan of salvation through His Son, Jesus Christ. Our Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross to redeem us from our sins, so that we can have this salvation, so that we can have this crown of life. He first loved us, so we must love Him as well, by not putting His name on shame, but instead make our efforts that the name of the Lord be glorified through us. We fall into sin because of temptations. We must be aware that the greatest danger is temptation to give up and yield to sin. As I have said, temptations are something to be resisted. It is a spirit. If we are sensitive with the spirits, we can feel what the spirit is working in that person. If it is from God or from the world. Because temptations are from the world. Hallelujah, Jesus. We fall into sin because we let the spirit of sin work in our lives. There is a transference of the spirits. For example, the spirit of gossip, the spirit of division, spirit of sexual immorality or unforgiving spirits. This, if one believer has these spirits, these spirits can transfer from one believer to another if we are not careful. And before we know, not only this believer has these spirits, but also this one, that one, and the other one. And the whole church will be affected, and the church will suffer. This is how the devil works, to push the church down. Every one of us experiences temptations, not only this believer, not only that believer. All of us, even I, experience temptations, because this is the work of the devil, to destroy us and to bring us back to the world again, where we were before. Temptations are not always from outside the church. They are also from within. So we must be careful, because Satan is wise. It depends upon us if we let these temptations work in our lives. This is the test of our faith. 1 Corinthians 10:13.